This is the title to my 2019 Porsche 911S. Just to demonstrate to you that I'm not one of those fake YouTubers that's going out and renting cars. I like getting money, I got time to get it. Target on me, so my car's a tinny. Dancing with the devil, I don't bargain with it. Bobbing in a dash and the stick is witty. And I hit the 4-5 on the west side. But I'm from the east side, this how we slide. This how we ride, yeah, yeah, this how we ride. Make it easy like 1, 2, 3. Go, 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 go. In this video, we're going to talk about why unemployment is still extremely high. If you didn't know, unemployment right now is higher than it was during the Great Recession. And one of the reasons that unemployment is higher is corporations have kind of figured some stuff out. So you and I are going to have a conversation on this. One of the things that is happening is with people working from home, corporations have figured some stuff out. And they have figured out that they don't need as many people as they had. They don't need them. And this is a really big, big part of what's going on. Because if you didn't know, and you can go ahead and fact check me, and you can look up these numbers, that unemployment has been over 800,000 people since it dropped down from the 6 million people per week. It's been 800,000 up to 900,000 week in and week out. And, you know, it's kind of funny because one of the things that is happening is that this is exposing the multiple economies that we have. We have my economy. My economy is people who are making money, doing well. I mean, other than the fact that I can't go out like I used to, well, actually, I still go out. I go on dates, I do things, I still meet people. I'm going to say that's been cut by maybe 30%. So that's only been the big change in my life because my money's still coming in, I'm still doing well, I'm still making money. So that's one sector of the economy. And the other sector of the economy is people who cannot pay their rent, people who cannot pay their car payments, people who cannot pay their health insurance, people who cannot pay daycare for their kids, people who are really on the edge of financial disaster. So that's the bottom half of the sector that we have. You know, there's a level of polarization because essentially the pandemic, frankly for me, was the best year that I ever had financially. Best year ever. And part of that was positioning. I was positioned to do well before the pandemic even got started. But one of the things that's happening is, let's take what's happening with the stock market. During the pandemic, a lot of people, let's go to Wall Street Bets. Many people went to Wall Street Bets and they started having conversation with it was supposedly 3 million members of that organization. I think it's probably like 10, maybe 12 million now. I don't know. I haven't checked. But people started to educate themselves about stocks and options and things that they could do to make some money because they were sitting at home depending on a flimsy stimulus check or, you know, the unemployment with the $600 differential was sweet because that put some people in a position where they were making more money sitting at home chilling than they were making when they were working. So that was really sweet, and I had a feeling that that wasn't going to come back, and it didn't. I think it's now an additional $300 per week. And once again, I'm going to make some predictions that this year is going to be the best year for corporate citizens, and it's going to be a very bad year for average people. Let's talk about that. Right now, if you are a person, because right now there's someone who's going to be listening to this, they have a job right now. And within a very short period of time, they're no longer going to have a job. They're going to be one of those people sitting at home, wondering what happened and trying to scratch out some way where they can start making some income. So I actually feel that my business is going to boom because I teach people how to make money. And I think that this is going to become epic this year because I feel that the mass level of unemployment is going to continue because corporations, because the first levels
of unemployment were pandemic induced. And we got to close down, we can't make money, so we got to let these people go. That was the first round. The second round was corporate America going, hey, we don't need John, we don't need Sally, and we can still make the same amount of money. Because see, I'm not the only one that made a lot of money during this pandemic. Home Depot, Lowe's, some restaurants, DoorDashers. There was certain segments of people who did really, really well, even though we had a pandemic. And one of the things that you gotta understand is corporate America is ruthless. Corporate America's like, hey, we don't need them, they gotta go. I don't care if they have a mortgage, I don't care if they have a family, I don't even care if they have a kid with cancer, don't care, they gotta go. And this is the third round of layoffs. You're gonna see a lot of middle managers get laid off. You're gonna see a lot of six-figure earners get laid off because corporate America has figured out that we don't need these people. And it's gonna be a very dark year for many folks, because what's gonna happen is we're gonna have a big reset and a shift. I've talked about the global reset. Global economies are resetting all over the nation, all over the world, they're resetting. And what we're gonna have are people who are now homeowners, they're gonna become renters. The rental market is going to be amazingly robust for probably the next 5 to 10 years. See, here's the thing, because this is one of the things I see with this massive level of unemployment. And this is a very high level of unemployment. This level of unemployment is higher than the level of unemployment during the Great Recession, which literally set people back 2 decades. There are still people who have not recovered from the Great Recession. They've not recovered. Let's go ahead and talk about what happens with your income. Let's say you're in your 20s, you're just getting out of college, you're making money, you're doing your thing. Here's something that you don't understand. You got 30 years to make your money, because what's gonna happen is you're going to become more experienced, you're going to start making more money, you're gonna start doing certain things. And what's gonna happen is when you get to your 40s and your early 50s, your income is going to stagnate, or it's going to reverse. There are many, many people who were making good money in their 30s and 40s, and they got to their 50s, and then they lost their job and they could not find an equal job. I have several friends who are in their 50s who are not making the money they were making 10, 15 years ago, because they got let go and they could not get a comparable or similar job. So here's the thing, and I'm about to tell you, you're in your 20s, your teeth are all white, and you're fresh, and you're all in shape. Enjoy yourself, because it ain't gonna last. Because what's gonna happen is your income is going to go down. There's an income chart. The average 60-year-old makes 50,000. The average 50-year-old makes 50,000, and it just keeps going down and down and down. Because essentially, what happens is once you get kicked out of the corporate plantation at a certain age, it becomes hard for you to get back in. This is why people who work at a company and stay there for decades and stuff, they're fortunate. Because I actually have a friend who's only had one job in her life, and she is about to turn 50, and she's been in her company almost 30 years, and she's been promoted several times, she's been relocated a few times, and her corporate ticket has been punched, and she's good to go. And she's gonna retire from this company with a pension. Not a 401k, but she's gonna retire with a pension. That is very, very rare. And what you're gonna see is many people shift down. You're gonna see a lot of people, like I said earlier, there were people who were homeowners, they're going to become renters. There were people who were renters, renting a house, they're gonna move into an apartment. And there were people who were in apartments, they're gonna be homeless. So you're gonna see a gradual shift down, unless you start to make serious decisions for yourself. Because like I said, right now, there's someone who's listening to this video and it's like, Lyndon is full of it, he's full of crap, my job is secure, I'm good to go. And then they're gonna like, hey Bob, we need to see you in the office. The next thing you know, you're gonna be laid off, and you're gonna be like, well, damn, he was right. Because one of the things that you've got to understand and you've got to acknowledge is corporate America is ruthless. They don't care about you. And you can't beat them, join them. Because one of the things that's going to be very evident from this global reset is the winners and the losers. People who are winning, people who understand the game, people who know how to play the game. Because one of the things that is going on is people don't understand that there's a game that's being played. Let's take the guys who were at Wall Street Bets. That was a participation in the game for many average, ordinary Americans for the first time in their lives. That they actually were participating in the right game, playing it by the rules, and winning. And this is one of the reasons, because I have a video that's going to drop on Savage Finance that talks about money schemes. Be sure to check that out. That's going to drop in the morning. But right now, there are so many people who are going to be trampled by this shift because they're not paying attention. They're not playing the game. They don't even understand that there is a game to be played. They don't understand that they are a chess piece on a chessboard and they're a pawn. They don't understand this until they're 65 years old. They don't have any retirement and they're living with their kids if they're fortunate. If they're fortunate to be living with their kids. If they're fortunate. Because like I said, many of you are in your 20s. You don't understand, unless you start a business, your income has a vector. It goes up and then it comes down. And if you start a business, you can be 80 years old and be making $1 billion as a business owner. How many 80-year-olds do you see in corporate America who don't own the company? You don't see any. Look at Joe Biden. Look at Donald Trump. Look at all these people running for president. You notice that they may be 70 or almost 80 years old, but they got pep in their step. They're different. They're very, very different. They're not normal people. And if you're a normal person, what's going to happen to you is you're going to really suffer some dire consequences because this global reset is going to be ruthless. It's not going to care. And you have to make a decision, because I know that there are many YouTubers who's like, everyone can't be a business owner. Everyone isn't cut out for entrepreneurship. I'm going to disagree. Do you want to eat? Do you want to put gas in your car? Do you want to drive? Do you want to pay your mortgage? I think the answer to all of those questions is yeah. So you're cut out to be an entrepreneur. You may not want to do it because it's hard. But as I showed you in the beginning, becoming an entrepreneur is the only job that's going to pay you what you want to be paid. It's the only job. Like, I started off this video with the ATM receipt. That's what I paid myself this year from my company. And if you don't get on this corporate citizen bandwagon, you're going to get left behind. And it's just a matter of time, because it's going to hit you. Because this is one of the things. The funny thing happened to me. As you get older, certain things just happen. Like this weekend, I woke up with a little hitch in my back, and I don't know what I did. I wasn't working out. It was my day off, and fortunately, I was working out today, and it disappeared. But as you get older, certain things just happen. It just happened. And well, this is what's going to happen. It may not catch up with you in your 20s. It may not catch up with you in your 30s. But at some point, it's going to catch up with you. And once again, if you are just an average American who's not playing the corporate game, not becoming a corporate citizen, it's going to catch up with you sooner or later. And the worst time, you know, these things kind of happen at the worst times possible. This is when they pop up. This is when they happen. This is when things start to happen at the worst time possible. You never have these emergencies when you have a lot of money in the bank. You never have these events when you're living well. But once again, this year is going to be rough for a lot of people. And like I said, I'm not trying to brag or boast, but the reason that this year was good for me is because I was playing the game. I've been playing the game for almost 2 decades. And because I was already playing the game, because I already worked out, I was already on the field, I was already dressed out, and I was playing the game, when this pandemic thing happened, it created a situation for me to make a lot of money, more money than I've ever made in my life. And one of the things that's going to happen to people is if you start playing the game, like these guys at Wall Street Bets, they start playing the game. And a lot of them won. But if you're not playing the game, not playing, becoming a corporate citizen, if you're not doing that, if you're not being a part of that corporate paradigm, because essentially, let's talk about the corporate game. Like Wall Street Bets, people are making money on a company whose corporate profile is literally trash. GameStop is going out of business at some point. That's what's going to happen. They're going to go out of business. But because they're corporate and they can be manipulated, you have these Wall Street bet guys and these hedge funds playing this game, and the hedge fund guys got caught with their pants down and they got spanked. And there's so many things that you can do as a corporate citizen. There's so many ways that you can play the corporate game. You can be an investor and learn how to invest in stocks the correct way. Or you can start your own corporation and become a full-fledged corporate citizen. But I'm here to tell you, 2021 is going to be a great year for some people, and it's going to be a horrible year for other people. It's going to be very, very bad for some people. It's going to be bad. So I'm not going to speak gently to you guys, because a lot of you have been watching me for like many years. This channel is 11 years old, about to hit 100,000 next few days. And one of the things that you guys, if I've been straight with you, you need to stop playing around, and you need to get your business started. You need to get your investments going, and you need to get started this year, because if you don't, you will be left behind. You will be left behind. You will be one of the forgotten people. You're going, like right now, you know, you're living in your apartment, you're eating well, you got a nice little job. That's going to change. Don't know when it's going to change, but that's going to change. And if you do not start playing this corporate game, it is going to catch up with you. Now, I was 32 when I started this path. So 32, got the job, Rent-A-Crate. Then 33-ish. So at 34 is when I started my first company, and I'm 54. So I've been playing the corporate game for 20 years. And essentially, if I had a job and I was just working a job, my life would not be what it is right now. I wouldn't be living in this house. I wouldn't be driving these cars. I wouldn't have money in the bank. My life would not be, I would be an average American, because essentially there was a study, you know, that 25% of Americans have $25,000 or more in the bank. But the other 75% of America don't even have $5,000. So 75% of America is two paychecks away from being broke. Two. And if it wasn't for friends and family, when times get hard, a lot of these people would be on the streets. A lot of them, if it wasn't for Big Mama or Granddad or Big Daddy, they would be on the streets. And this is one of the things, because right now, we have more social networks and social safety nets that we've ever had before. If this was 1930 and this had happened, it would have been way worse than it was, because there was no social safety nets, and there would have been no $600 premium on top of your unemployment. So essentially, what you need to do is to set yourself up where you become a corporate citizen, where you can start building, because it's going to be a process. It's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take you a little time. But you want to go ahead and build your corporate entity, start playing the corporate game, and start doing these things so you can play the right game. Because 2021 is going to be somewhat of a repeat of 2020. We're going to have the same thing with football and basketball and the protocols. Now, I will say that people are starting to travel more. I had to go somewhere. I had to get on the plane. Plane was packed. Everyone had on the mask. So we're moving past this, but this global reset is going to last us for the next 5 years. This is not, you know, we're going to be wearing masks in 2023 probably. Some people might even be wearing them in 2024. I know that, you know, that people want to be tired over this. I have a girl I'm dating. She sent me some Snapchat. She was out in the club. They were dancing. They were doing karaoke. No one had on the mask. So people, you know, it's a weird thing. But to my larger point, you got to become a corporate citizen. You got to get out of being in a position where someone can call you into an office and say, "Hey, Ed, we got to let you go." I don't know. That happened to me. When that happened to me with T-Mobile. Well, it was VoiceStream. Now it's T-Mobile. I made a commitment to myself that was never going to happen to me again. I was never going to be told to walk in someone's office and say, "Hey, man, you got to go." That was never going to happen to me again, and it hasn't happened to me again. And I don't want that to happen to you. So go below, and there's the money management course. Get that, because most of you are messing up your money. And then there's many free courses if you don't have the money for the corporate toolbox. And if you want to get in the corporate toolbox, we're getting ready to get into some seriously juicy content. content, some seriously juicy training. So that's all I got for you guys. I will see you in the next one.